there's so much about Linda Tripp that I feel that you tap into that maybe people who like Mark and me who were observing at the time.
That's Ryan.
No, I'm just I'm reminding him
of
who Mark was at one point. But we were watching news briefs, but I think that you get to know her in a totally different way and bring that to the surface a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, I think the scripts were really helpful in that way. You know, sometimes as an actor, you're trying to invent something out of nothing on the page. This was not one of those experiences. The scripts were so wonderful. And there is so much footage of Linda walking in and out of her home because the paparazzi were just camped on her doorstep at that time. So that was kind of my way into the character, was actually from the outside in, which is not usually how I work or have worked. So
and people thought obviously she betrayed a friend of hers.
And she did betray.
But she would also say she did it for Monica's own good.
I think she did believe she was doing it for Monica's own good, and I think she also was disgusted by the behavior of the president of the United States and thought it was just a horrible, hideous thing to do as the leader of the free world.
And you sound just like her.
Yeah, I had a voice. I had a dialect coach. I had a movement coach.
Movement coach?
Yeah, I had to have a movement coach because, you know, Linda had a very kind of collapsed way of walking.
Huh. Yeah.
So I put my nose, this is the most actressy thing I've ever said, but because her nose was kind of always in everyone's business, I kind of let my nose lead the way.
Yeah.
And so my nose would turn before my...
Yeah.
But I worked with a teacher named Julia Crockett who helped me craft the way I walked.